Hey guys, welcome back to the Oilers Fanatic. Today I'm going to start a new series of videos looking at possible free agent acquisitions for the Edmonton Oilers this summer. I'm going to start by covering all the upcoming unrestricted and restricted free agents currently on the Oilers roster and giving my opinion on who stays and who goes. From there, I'll branch out to the unrestricted players around the league. I'll start with forwards and then dive into defense and goaltenders. I've already released my picks for the Edmonton Oilers 2020-2021 roster, and I took a look at a possible Oilers goaltending duo in Mike Smith and Alex Staluk. You'll find links to those videos below and at the end of this video. Let's get started. Here are the unrestricted free agent forwards for the Edmonton Oilers. Ryan Nugent-Hopkins, the biggest Oilers UFA, and a player I have listed on my roster. According to the latest reporting, negotiations are not going well between Nugent-Hopkins and the Oilers, and Nuge may go to market. Several teams would be interested in Nuge, but I think the biggest threat is, of course, the NHL's newest team, the Seattle Kraken. Seattle undoubtedly has their eyes on Nuge, and if he's looking for a significant raise, they will be his best bet. I think ultimately cooler heads will prevail, and Nuge is back in oil country next season. Alex Chiasson. Chiasson has been a good Oiler, great teammate, and a great veteran presence, but unfortunately the offense just isn't there, and it doesn't show signs of coming back. The Oilers desperately need secondary scoring, and at this point in his career, Chiasson isn't going to provide much. I'd be okay with him on the fourth line, or as an extra forward at league minimum salary. Otherwise, I'm afraid Alex needs to go. Tyler Ennis. I really like Tyler Ennis, but as much as I like him, I couldn't find a spot for him in my lineup. I think he's too good to be on the fourth line, but I also think he's not good enough for my second or third line. Also to be noted, Dave Tippett barely played him this year. Like Chiasson, Ennis has been a great Oiler, but I don't see him back on this roster next season. Gaetan Haas. A depth center for the Oilers, I have Haas as a possibility to come back on my roster on the fourth line. Haas has shown flashes of being able to do the job, and he hasn't done anything that makes me dismiss him outright. Unless someone new is brought in via free agency, I think the fourth line center position comes down to Gaetan Haas or Jujhar Khaira. Joachim Nygaard. This will be short. Nygaard is already gone, signing a new six-year contract in Sweden. He struggled with injury and getting playing time, and it was best that he moved on. Patrick Russell. When he's on the roster, he's primarily been the Oilers' 14th forward, and he has yet to score an NHL goal. I've been rooting for him to get it, but it's time for him to try and get it somewhere else. If no NHL contract is in his future, I'm sure an AHL contract with the Bakersfield Condors is a possibility. Now we take a look at the unrestricted defenseman for the Edmonton Oilers, Adam Larsson. Larsson is on my roster, and last we heard, a new deal was close to being done. Larsson had a fantastic bounce back season, and it was likely his best so far for the Edmonton Oilers. He's strong and reliable, and I'm thrilled to know he should be back. Tyson Barrie. I really like Tyson Barrie, and I was thrilled when the Oilers landed him last summer. He fit in perfectly with our roster, and I would love to have him back. However, I think his fate is tied to Oscar Klefbom. If Klefbom returns from injury, that likely all but ensures that Barrie goes to free agency. From the sounds of it, he wants to test the market either way, but I think his return requires Klefbom to retire or be claimed by Seattle in the expansion draft. I see it as the only way the Oilers can make the money work. Dmitry Kulikov. Acquired at the trade deadline, Kulikov did nothing to impress me. I watched him constantly give the puck away, and he was scratched in Game 4 in the playoffs. I think that should tell us everything we need to know. Slater Cuckoo. Cuckoo had a fantastic start to the year, but a devastating injury was sidelined him until the end of the year, returning just before the playoffs. He's probably a bit of a long shot to come back. I had trouble finding a spot for him. But if they can figure something out, I'd welcome him back with open arms. Lastly, in goal, Mike Smith. Ken Holland wants him back. Smith had an outstanding season and seems really happy in Edmonton. I think you can pretty much call this a sure thing. The key here is who the Oilers can find to play with Smith. It can't be Mikko Koskinen. I'll take a look at some UFA goalies and eventually goalies that could be acquired through trade in upcoming videos. Okay guys, let's take a look at the restricted free agents for the Edmonton Oilers. It's a much shorter list and only contains forwards. Jujhar Khaira. I have Jujhar returning on my roster. He struggled at the start of last season, but started to come around as the season progressed. He's definitely not a flashy player, but he's a good team guy and a serviceable fourth line forward. I think the Oilers bring him back. Dominic Cahoon. Cahoon was one of the disappointments of the season. We all had high hopes that he would recapture that chemistry he had with Leon Draisaitl from their playing time in Germany, but nothing of any significance transpired. He showed little glimpses of being a strong player here and there, but I don't think it was enough to justify bringing him back. The Oilers need to upgrade on the wings, and he will be a casualty of that. Kailer Yamamoto. How do you not love Kailer Yamamoto? A feisty little player, he will take on anyone and is relentless. Unfortunately though, he didn't score too much, and that is something that will need to be addressed going forward. In my lineup, I dropped him to the third line, with the possibility of moving up when needed. He's a valuable player for the Oilers, and with the season he had, his next contract will be a shorter bridge one. There should be big things in the Amos future. Devin Shore. Arriving in camp on a tryout, Shore proved he belonged and delivered a very strong season for the Oilers. I'd love to have him back, and I have him penciled in on my roster on the fourth line. A fantastic depth forward, Shore impressed, and should be back with the Oilers next season. Alright, that's all for today guys. Sound off in the comments below and let me know what you think. Enjoying the videos? Please hit that subscribe button. Take care, and I'll catch you next time.